99 Jams, the afternoon get down with a tough guy, DJ Entice.
Your girl, Super Cindy, and live in the studio.
Talk about it.
Repping North Miami for life. Kiddo Marv. Hey, kiddo.
What's up? What's up?
You making moves, kiddo.
You know we grinding.
You know, when I first met you, I never, like, understood. Like, I thought you were just calling yourself, like, Lil, but changed it to Kiddo. But Kiddo has, like, a bigger meaning. It's not, like, Lil Wayne or Lil something. It's not Kiddo Mar. It's Kiddo. What does Kiddo stand for?
Kiddo stands for Kings in Denial Don't Overcome.
Okay. Kings in Denial Don't Overcome.
That's dope.
That's so positive.
Yeah.
You know. Did you come up with it, or is that the name of your crew? Because I see there's other kiddos, or did they just copy your name?
Nah, that's what happens. You know, you have a path, and, you know, people feel like it's the right path to follow. They'll just come. So that name came about. I was always Kiddo. Like, since middle school, they used to call me Kiddo. They ain't stand for nothing. The older I got, you know, I started understanding things a little more better, gained more knowledge. So one day I just was, you know, I was sleeping. And then it came in my dream and something. Like, I just woke up, like, Kings in the Now to Overcome.
And you know what's so dope? That you really do have a following of, like, the young people. Not that you're old, but I'm just saying, like, the kids love you. Like, the middle school, high school, all your songs, they know every word. Why do you think, like, that young population just attaches to you?
Because they relate to me. You feel me? Like, what I talk about, you know, what I do, how I dress, they relate to me. They look at me as somebody that been through what they've been through, or what they going through. So they, you know, people's champ.
You get do you get a lot of people that come up to you now? Like, oh my God, Kiddo.
A lot.
Yeah.
A lot. And there's some people that just come and just stare at you and you don't know whether you got to mug them or.
Right. Like, why are you staring at me though?
Yeah. Like, because you remember, we still from the street. So we still got to have our guards up.
Exactly. So, exactly.
You know, we don't know.
Like, for those that haven't heard your music, like, what is your background? You rep the 305, you're from the 305. Like, what's your story?
Well, my story was, I was born here, Parkway. But I was raised in Haiti till I was, like, 7 years old.
Okay.
So all my family is in Haiti. I don't have any family in the USA Miami, except my mom and dad.
Wow.
So it was like, yeah.
You know, that says it
reps,
all.
That's why I rep so hard. I can't fake it.
Okay.
I can't. You feel me? So.
Zoe for life.
Zoe to the bone.
Right.
Kiddo, what does the song mean, Drip?
What do you think
it means? The sauce. The drip. You explained it.
What do you think it means?
I thought it meant the nastiness.
The nastiness of water.
What the nastiness?
The nastiness of water.
Oh, gosh. Next subject. Next question.
Next question.
Let me get my question. There she goes. Get out of here. So, congratulations. Your album, Kings in Denial, Don't Overcome 2.
Yes, ma'am.
This morning, it came out.
Yes, ma'am.
It's on all streaming platforms, Apple Music. Like, how long did it take you to complete this project?
Most of the songs, I had recorded it, like, last year. I record every day.
I see you in the studio every day on your social media.
Yeah, so it's like, you know, it's some songs that, I can't drop it because I have a vision. I need this person on it. So if it takes a whole year, we gonna wait.
It's amazing because you have features on the album. Some of the people featured Wyclef Jean, Ball Greasy, Sam Sneak, Trick Daddy, Major 9, Benny Moon, which is a compa song that you have there, and my girl Tokyo Jets is on the album.
Yeah, that queen.
Ooh, talk about the song you have with Tokyo Jets.
Heartbreaker.
There's no clean version for it, so
I'm trying to break your heart.
Yeah, basically.
You didn't really love me from the start, Trick.
That's where we'll end it. But what is it about? Like, it's you and her going back and forth, and you guys used to date, and then who cheated on
who? No. We didn't. We never dated.
What is the song?
Oh, okay.
The song. See, the girl that I made the song about. She's not a rapper, so I had to find the perfect person to, like, get that emotion that I needed, and she's the right one.
What is the song about, though? Like, what is it?
I'm trying to dodge it.
All right, but you're really trying to dodge it. No, we're talking about it.
One day, you know, I was laying down, you feel me? I was scrolling on Twitter, and then there's this girl, like, she tweeting about me, and I seen a couple things, and I was just mad. So, you said, you know what? I'm gonna break her heart, dog. I'm gonna break her. I'm gonna say the rudest thing.
Oh, okay. Like, I'm gonna say so you busted her bubble.
I'm gonna say the meanest thing I could say
to her
on a song for her, and she gonna know it's for her.
Wow. And she knows it's for her. Have you spoken to her?
Yeah, we good now. We cool.
Oh god,
like, it was like an emotion. That's the beauty of music. You feel me? You put your emotion on the paper, and you just let it out. You feel me?
And then it turned into a song. She heard it. You guys cussed each other out, but then you guys made up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, we good, you feel me?
How good now? Kiddo, do you have a girlfriend? Do you have a girlfriend? You see how I asked the question?
I have an album that just dropped today.
And she's your girlfriend.
We got an album that dropped today.
You feel me?
You know the ladies love you, kiddo. That's why I want to know, do you have a girlfriend? Like, why are you dodging the question?
I'm not dodging the question. I just, you know, Heartbreaker is out.
Okay.
I'm trying to break your heart. I don't think anybody... you know,
wants that right now.
Don't look at me because I'm not gonna save you from the question though. Like, I'm gonna egg Cindy on to keep pushing to get that question out. You feel me? Like, don't look at me.
Nah, but you know, ladies, if you ready for a Haitian, a king that, you know, take care of himself, his family, and don't cheat, you know, when you're ready though, don't come when you're not ready. When you're ready, holla at your boy.
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say, don't come for me.
No, he sounded like he's ready.
Though. I need you a queen. You got to be ready.
Okay. I love that. So let's move on to the Kings. Wyclef Jean. How did you connect with Wyclef Jean?
Kiddo
Marv featuring Wyclef Jean is amazing.
Put so it big.
How I got to Wyclef, shout out to Lucci.
Mm-hmm.
That's his cousin.
Okay.
So Wyclef came down to Lil Haiti one time, and he hollered at Lucci to bring me out.
Okay.
And they just made that happen. And ever since, Lucci just kept connecting the pieces.
Mm-hmm.
And you too, remember when he came to 99 Jams?
Yeah, he asked me who's up and coming, and I definitely named you as one of the up and coming.
So thank you.
No worries, I appreciate it, you feel me? And so, other features. You know what? I think you, Major Nine, and Sam Sneak need to form a group.
We just gotta do a project together.
Nah,
like, you guys come out with songs and it's so fire. You guys should just make a whole album. Like, Sam Sneak is fire. Major Nine, fire. Kiddo Marv, fire.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you just form a group?
That's a good idea. But, you know, everybody is their
individual
own bosses. Everybody has their own, you know, companies,
movement,
labels.
Sound,
like,
yeah,
we're talking about business owners. Everybody have our own business. So it's like, we could do our thing. We could make money with each other. We could do a project with each other. We could do multiple projects with each other.
Mm-hmm.
And that's dope. We helping each other out.
It's like that.
We family, you hear me?
So what made you do the song that sounds like has compa in it? It's like with the compa artist, Benny Moon. Like, why did you decide to do that?
Because you see how my cover is? Kings in and Out Don't Overcome. With the Haitian whole background. Basically, the whole cover shows you, just by looking at it, you could tell how I was raised, like, just real simple. And that shows me how I'm a king. Like, my mom treat me like a king, no matter, you know, what we have, you know, where we stay. So I just had to put a real cultural song to just show the world. Like,
the
first thing you gonna hear is track one, Zoe to the Bone. This is who I am, you feel me? So
I love that. And, you know, shouts to your mom and dad who were at your listening party last night at Bar Idol. And they, you know, it was the most hilarious thing. Like, they were supporting. I saw the dad with his drink in his hand, bobbing his head. His mom was dancing. And then all of a sudden, when it was like wrapping up, everybody's saying, okay, we're leaving. The parents were like, wait a minute, y'all didn't cut that cake. It's like a typical Caribbean parent. Like, wait, where's the cake? What happened to the cake? And he was like, it's too nice of a cake to cut.
That
they're like,
too
cut
good
the
to
cake.
Eat right now. I just needed a couple pictures.
Kiddo, your parents always supported you?
Yeah, man.
Like,
my
always
biggest
supported the rap and all that?
At first, like, you know, when I was growing up, I was, you know, made mistakes. I was bad and stuff. So what they seen in music is my passion and how it really, like, keep me out of trouble and make me make money the right way.
Mm.
So they all for it, like. They my biggest fan. They be calling Haiti like, yo, go on YouTube, Facebook.
Facebook.
They be lit.
That's typical Facebook. Who does your squad consist of? I don't see you rolling with like 50 people, but like you always really have like the same people.
The same people I grew up with my whole life.
And who's your squad? Who are your people?
It's, you know, you mean like, who I'm
like
with in the
crew
music.
Yeah, like music-wise.
You know, my boy, Mini Me, Simply Anique, you know.
Of course.
Photo T, Dave. And it's a lot of people that surround behind the scene, you know. Mm-hmm. They just, you know, they don't care support. For that. They don't want no shout outs. They don't care about that. They don't. They
don't care for that.
They just do it just to do it. You feel me?
You right. know, like everything that I do, I always surround the theme of royalty and queens and crowns, like my Queens Don't Compete album.
Yeah.
And it's so dope that you know, you have the Kings in Denial Don't Overcome. That's what consists of your name, the KIDDO, the acronym.
Yeah.
So why Kings? Like, what about it? And how important is a king having a queen to you?
Hmm.
That's so important because let me give y'all some game real quick. This is why they say I got the sauce. You feel me?
Like, oh, that's what the sauce is.
So okay. Check this out.
You got the drip.
Oh, check this out. A queen is your backbone.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? Like, I can only look straight left and right.
Right.
And my queen is like behind me.
Mm-hmm.
She could actually look at, she could tell me like, hey, watch out for this person right there because he's looking at you a funny way.
Mm.
He just clapped you up, right? Mm-hmm. And then you just look the other way. But she's going to keep the eye
and
out.
She
you
saw.
Feel me? So she's your backbone. Like, I don't care what nobody tell me. Like, if a girl say you look good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, damn, you look fresh right now. I like what you got on. What you going to do? Go to the store and go try to look for the same type
right.
of outfit.
Yeah.
She motivates you.
Mm-hmm.
So if a queen tell you you can fly, what you going to try to do? Hey, I can fly, boy. She bad.
So that support
so
I'm going to
just go
you.
Jump and try to fly. So, yeah, you need somebody that's right there on your level that can motivate you in, you know, any way.
I love that. So your album, let's wrap things up. Your album, Kings in Denial, Don't Overcome 2, available on all streaming platforms. And like we said previously, Wyclef, Balgreezy, Sam Sneak, Trick Daddy is on the album, Major 9, Tokyo Jets. So, how did you link up with Trick Daddy real quick? How'd you do that?
Trick called me one day.
Okay.
He sent like three people at me. And mm-hmm. he sent Mike Smith, and he sent Chad, and B. Smith.
Okay.
And I talked to him, and he was like, little bro, man, you nice, man. You putting on for the city, da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
We need to get on a record.
Okay.
Don't come on my vibe. Just do you. How you rep your culture, just do you. And I'm finna come, you know?
And the song with Trick is titled?
I'm too young. I needed that,
I that.
Doug Holiday trick, the,
yeah.
the trick that the kids.
Yeah,
trick
daddy. Dope.
So,
yeah.
And that's what we hear. So who is some of the production on the album?
We got DJ on the beat.
Mm-hmm.
He from Miami. We got Nikki Hot Beat. She from Miami. Mook So Live, you know, he from Miami.
So 305 to the fullest.
Yeah, we got two other producers. I don't really know their name, but they sent, you know.
Sent beats and you got them.
Yeah, we did the business. You know?
So everybody, make sure you stream Kings in Denial. Don't overcome
too.
You guys jinxed me, I
you
swear.
You gotta say that.
KIDDO Marv is live in the studio. KIDDO, keep doing your thing. Where can they follow your movements?
All the social medias, KIDDO Marv, you know.
Okay, KIDDO MARV.
And Snapchat for the queens, you know.
For the queens. Snapchat is for the queens.
Queens
huh?
in and out, don't overcome.
Tatianas. For all the Tatianas. Go to the Snapchat.
I don't like Tatianas. I like queens.
Okay, good answer.
There you go.
Queen.
Right.